friends, welcome to my channel Smart Learning Academy. In this video tutorial, I am going to discuss about the class 2 transposable elements. Please do watch my previous videos, that is transposable elements and class 1 transposable elements, that will help you to understand the class 2 transposable elements. As I have discussed, class 2 transposable elements can be divided into 3 parts, and it can be found into the either in virus or in prokaryotes or in eukaryotes. So let's discuss transposable elements present in the bacteria or in prokaryotes. In bacteria, the transposable elements or transposons can be simple or can be composite. In simple transposable elements, there is a IS element, or in complex, it can be composite or non-composite. Let's discuss about the IS element present in the bacteria. IS elements is also known as insertion sequence element are the most common transposons present in the bacterial genome. There are more than 20 different insertion sequence element reported in the bacteria, that is IS1, IS2 to the IS20. It is conservative in nature and it can work cut and paste mechanism, that means it can move from one position to another position directly as a DNA. The size of IS element is 1 to 2 kb, which is flanked by the inverted repeats and direct repeats. Inverted repeats containing about 50 base pair. You can see in this diagram, it contains about the 50, less than or equal to 50 base pair, which is already flanked by the direct repeats. The size of direct repeats is 5 to 11 base pair. It is 5 to 11 base pair, and the transposable elements, that is IS element, is responsible for the. There is gene segment present in the IS element, that is insertion sequence element. These genes transcribed into the mRNA and which is translated into the protein, which is known as transposase. Transposase is very specific to the inverted repeats and it is very specific to the IS sequences. So this transposase bind to the inverted repeats, that means it binds to the inverted repeats, which cuts the IS element from this segment. As you know, the IS element works in the cut and paste mechanism, that means the transposase enzymes required for the functioning of IS element in the bacteria. The IS elements can work with the help of two mechanisms, that is conservative mechanism and by complex mechanism. Let's see one by one what is conservative mechanism and what is complex mechanism. As I told you, the transposable elements present in the bacteria, that is known as IS element, can work in two manner. The first one is conservative transposition by IS elements, and second one is composite transposition by the IS element. Let's discuss about the conservative transposition by IS element. It shows it is a conservative, that means it works on the cut and paste mechanism. Here it is the direct repeats and it is the inverted repeats. The mRNA transcribed from the IS element translated into the transposase, and transposase act at the site of inverted repeats and cut the site into the blunted manner. After this, the IS element can be free after the digestion of transposase. Then this IS element can be inserted into the target site by homologous and non-homologous enjoining. This is the conservative transposition by IS element. Let's discuss about the complex transposition mechanism by the IS element in the bacteria. The complex transposition mechanism can be found of two types, that is composite and non-composite. What is the composite complex transposition? That means when a gene present in between the two IS elements, when a gene present in between the two IS elements, that is IS1 and IS2, or you can say IS1, it can be the same IS elements or different IS element, then these phenomena or these transposons known as complex composite transposons or complex composite transposition. When more than one gene, gene 1 and gene 2 present within the single IS element, within the single IS element, when more than one genes present within the single IS element, here one gene flanked by the two insertion sequences. But in the non-composite, more than one gene present within the single insertion sequence, then it is known as non-composite complex transposons, or this phenomena of transposition is known as complex non-composite transposition. So this is all about the bacterial transposition by the IS element. Let's discuss about the eukaryotic transposition. Let's discuss one example in eukaryotic transposition, or eukaryotic transposable elements is ACDS, which is present in maize or corn. These transposable elements made up of two components. First is AC, which is autonomous in nature, and second is DS. AC has the size of 4.5 kb and the inverted repeats present in the AC is 11 base pair. The mechanism of action of ACDS is conservative, that means it acts with the help of cut and paste mechanism. AC is known as activator. McClintock found that DS elements could move in the presence of AC, but they are unable to move alone, while AC is capable of movement in the presence or absence of DS. That means AC can move alone or with in the presence of DS, but DS can move only in the presence of AC. DS is a deletion derivative of AC that contains the some special recombination sequences at its ends, where the transposase produced by AC can act. That means you can see in the diagram here, this is the AC sequence, and the transposase formed by the AC can act as an activator, which can move AC itself and DS segments also. But DS segment can form some deletion in the AC sequence. Here some deletion in the AC sequence which can form DS. If deletion is here, then it can form DS. Any deletion present in the AC forms the DS segment. Let's discuss one example of purple color formation in the maize. This is the DS segment which can be move their position in the presence of AC, and when AC is not present, there is no insertional activation possible. When AC is present, then the movement of DS is there, and when DS is integrate before the C gene, which breaks the DNA or which breaks the chromosome, and the purple color disappears, and C plus gene loses its functions, and it cannot regain its function when AC gene is present. When DS segments present or moves into the C gene or in between the C gene, that means insertional activation is occurs. In insertional activation, there is no formation of purple color, but when AC gene is present, then C gene can regains its function. But in this case, when the chromosome breaks, there is no regaining of the function in the presence of AC segments. The next example of eukaryotic transposition is present in the Drosophila. P element present in the genome of Drosophila. Transposition is done by the cut and paste mechanism, that is conservative. The size of P element is near about 2 kb, and which is flanked by the inverted repeats. The size of inverted repeats present in the Drosophila is near about 5 to 11 base pair. Here the simple representation is given, that is pre-mRNA formation of the transposable element P element, that is undergone for the alternative splicing, formation of mRNA1 and mRNA2. mRNA1 translated into the transposase, which is present in the germ cell, and the mRNA 2 gone for the repressor or repressor of the transposase, which is present in the somatic cell. This P element responsible for the hybrid dysgenesis in the Drosophila, which is known as PM system. When hybrid is sterile, then it is known as hybrid dysgenesis, and when hybrid is fertile, then it is known as genesis. This PM system is responsible for the hybrid dysgenesis in Drosophila, as I told you earlier. So let's see how this works in the Drosophila. So this is the PM system present in the Drosophila, where is two strain present, that is P cytotype and M cytotype. P means paternal contributing gene, the also known as P strain, in which P element is present, and M cytotype is maternal contributing gene, that is known as M strain, in which P element is absent. When the P strain is male and M strain is female, then offspring must be sterile. And when we cross between the P strain male or M strain female, or P strain male or P strain female, or M strain male or M strain female, then all the progenies present in this combination is fertile, but only one combination, when male from P strain and M from the female strain is crossed over, then progeny must be the sterile, that is known as hybrid dysgenesis. You can remember this trick, that is P from papa and M from mummy, that is mother from the M strain and P papa from the P strain, that is father from the P strain and mummy from the M strain. This combination leads the hybrid dysgenesis. This is the third classification of transposition: conservative transposition, that is viral transposition. As I told you, the class 2 transposition divided into three parts: bacterial transposition, eukaryotic transposition, and viral transposition. In viral transposition, they are basically two types: genome integrated and genome non-integrated. In genome integrated, the integration must be the random in the new viruses, and it is most study temperate phage. In genome integrated, the second one is when the integration is site specific, this must be present in the lambda phage. When genome is non-integrated, it is present in the P1 phage. So this is all about the class 2 transposition and class 2 transposable elements. Thank you for watching my video. If you like my video, please do like and subscribe my channel. Thank you very much.